So what we are going to do today is we are going to lubricate the steering rack. There are two types of power steering systems. First one is electrically assisted, secondly is hydraulically assisted. So the hydraulic assisted racks are running on power steering fluid, so they don't need lubrication as such. Fluid provides enough lubrication for the rack to work, but the electrical power steering system, as the name defines, runs through electrical motor. Rack doesn't need that much amount of lubrication, but after 5 to 6 years the rack starts to need a little bit of new lubrication it can work with. So very first thing, set up the jack, remove the tire. So the tire removed, hope you can see the zip tie, the end of the steering and boot. So we have to open that zip tie. If you are doing it first time, most probably you have a metal clip. You have to cut that metal clip out, and then you can move the steering boot towards yourself outside to have the access to the gear. Then we need to loosen this clamp and move it forward. So that we can slide the boot ahead. And this is our steering rack gear. We need to lubricate this shaft. As you can see, it needs to have good amount of lubrication, but at this point of time it doesn't have that. So that's the thing we need to lubricate. We need to do that on both sides. You can use high temperature grease, but I'm using just the normal one, lithium grease. Will do just fine. Do not forget to lubricate the gears on the rack gear. It is facing the front direction, so fill quite a lot of grease in between the gears so that they work smoothly. Okay, this is the other side. It's also running dry, so your ball gear connects to your track rod. Just in case you have not watched the video of track rods, you can click the right top corner of the screen. I'm linking a video of me changing the track rods. So after lubricating the rack, the next thing is placing the boot back again on its position and repeat the process with other side. So one more tip, if you are going to use zip ties, so place the zip tie on the position with a very light pressure so that it just holds the boot. It will be much better to grip it in this way as compared to you try to put the zip tie on the position after placing the boot back on.